The Lagos State Government is set to commence medical intervention against campaign against Schistosomiasis, a neglected tropical disease which is endemic in seven local government areas of the state. Commissioner for Health, Professor Akin Abayomi, who disclosed this to newsmen during a press briefing held at his office during weekend, explained that the state would commence mass administration of medicines for the control of Schistosomiasis in seven local government areas of the state. He listed the local government areas as including Ikeja, Ifako, Ijaye, Amuwa-Dofin, Oshodi, Isolo, Agege, Lagos Mainland, and Alimosho, adding that health workers will go around schools, homes, and other important places to administer on children between ages 5 and 14 from Monday the 2nd to Sunday the 8th of December 2019. And now we are joined by Dr. Kunle Daramola. He is the representative NTD unit from the Federal Ministry of Health. And also I have with me Dr. Akintoba Akintayo, who is the medical officer of health in Agege local government area. Good to have you both. Good afternoon, doctors.
Good afternoon. Thank you very much for having us.
So now let's begin with this very strange name, but this disease has been with us, especially in Nigeria, since 1881, according to World Health Organization. So what is Schistosomiasis to begin with? Dr. Kunle, if I would begin with you.
Thank you very much. Schistosomiasis is a parasitic infection that is caused by different species of Schistosoma. That's a blood fluke or a trematode. So it affects children mostly because it is found in ponds and water bodies that are contaminated by the larva of Schistosoma. And then the larva will have matured in very small snails that we call Bulinus species. And then when someone waits in water, you know, like children do, you know, the parasites don't need the permission. They just enter the skin straight away. And then it starts maturing, and then breeding eggs. And then by the time they move around the body, they start to drain all the nutrients from the person, loss of blood, and then anemia. So the nutrients that a child should use to develop is actually going to the parasites. And then, because we cannot see them, most times you see a child that you think is healthy, but is already infested by these worms. So it's a major one, and it's one of the neglected tropical diseases that we don't pay attention to because we wait for people to be sick before we take action, which should not be.
Okay, I know, of course, that there are activities that you have engaged in, which I would allow Dr. Akintoba to talk to us about that. But before we come to you to explain why the activities, I'll just ask you, why is it necessary for us to do it now? Why are we having this campaign now?
Well, as a society, we should pay more attention to diseases that have been with us for ages. Like we say, these are diseases of antiquity. And it's a shame that we're still talking about them in the 21st century. So, and another reason is the fact that when you have so many diseases in society, why not pick the ones that are easy to eliminate, to control? These are what we call the low-hanging fruits. There are free medicines donated by the World Health Organization. There are experts, there's expertise. All we need is just public awareness and the commitment to run the race to finish this eradication and elimination of this disease. So, and if we don't do this, the children that are the future of the country will already be losing out. And then even in terms of economic productivity, it doesn't make economic sense to be losing the best of our brains to diseases.
All right. You already mentioned the public awareness. So I'll come to you, Dr. Akintayo, to ask, what are the activities that you have started engaging in? You know, I know there's a week-long activities that you've started off already. So could you please highlight and tell us the essence of them?
First and foremost, for every public intervention to be successful, we need to do a proper community engagement. So we started engaging the World Health Committee members, the other relevant stakeholders in the local government, the executive chairman, the supervisors for health, the World Health Committee members, the education secretaries, and so on and so forth. Then thereafter, after the initial engagement, we assisted with the we collaborated with the World Health Committee members to enlist the implementers to enlist the implementers. Those are the people that will administer the medicines. So, and enlisting them, we have to ensure that they are properly trained. So we have trained them. And also we did social mobilization activities, which involves part of what we are doing now, media engagement. Within the community, we have done market storms and social mobilization activities, distribution of flyers, just to ensure that people are properly engaged and they know the relevance of this activity.
Okay, having said that, Dr. Kunle, I'll come to you now, but I want to read this very article that was published quite recent, just a few months ago, and it says that about 200 million people in some 74 countries are infected worldwide by this same schistosomiasis, and at least 600 million people are at risk of infection. Now, let's come to Nigeria. It says, an estimated 30 million Nigerians need to be treated annually for the disease. So it brings me to my next question, which is for you to please elaborate on the symptoms, the causes, and of course, now what is the medical intervention?
Okay, thank you very much. The symptoms include blood in the urine. You know, when a child is urinating and you see what we call frank blood inside the urine, urine should be amber or yellow, but when you start seeing red, you know, at a point, we also want to make sure that people in the community understand that there are some communities that believe it's a sign of good living, and that should change. Mm. Yes, they believe that means the child is now mature.
You mean when a child is urinating blood?
Yes.
It is a sign of good living?
There are, you might
that's
be surprised.
That's a strong myth there.
Yeah, so those are some of the things we're trying to counter. So when you have communities where boys are menstruating in quotes, because they're passing out blood, so that's strange. So we need to do more of public awareness. There could be rashes too, some other symptoms. There could be swollen abdomen, loss of appetite. Some children, you know, maybe they say they are not passing well in their exams and you start knocking their heads. Just deworm them, because it's the worms that is taking away the nutrients that they need for their brain to function. So some of these things are very important for us too. And then that's why the World Health Organization, through some pharmaceutical companies, have donated praziquantel, which is the medicine of choice to treat it. And it's special, it's free of charge, it's not to be sold anywhere else, it's for free. And then it has no side effect, it's safe and effective. You know, it might just make the children want to feel a little sleepy for about 30 minutes and that's all. So we advise that they take a lot of good food, not just light food, good food, before they take the medicine. So when the implementers who have been trained, when they go to schools, we advocate that they go around the break time and then they take it. So it's been given 20 years now to children around the world. So it is very safe and effective medicine. And so we just want parents to be assured that this is official government deworming. There are some other deworming that are also official. Like recently there was a maternal child, newborn and child out week, where they give some other kind of deworming drug, but that was for children 0 to 4 years. This is for children 5 to 14 years. So maybe with time we can even come up with other interventions for adults also, because Lagos State also has some other entities known as lymphatic filariasis. You see people with swollen legs begging for money, you know, and then you see people with soil transmitted amenorrheas, you know. So, and some of these diseases, prevention is actually the only option. For example, it's not just that prevention is better than cure. So we really want people to accept it and know that it is safe for all their children.
Okay. I know that you're the medical officer of health and you engage more with the people, Dr. Akintayo. What are the things you see? Do people understand? How do people receive, you know, all of the campaign activities that you've been doing so far?
I would say that the people have been very receptive, because we engage them with the adequate knowledge, bringing it down to the their level of understanding. And essentially, I believe that if we can sustain the momentum, it would definitely be a good gain for us as a nation, that we are working towards eliminating a neglected tropical disease.
Okay. Having said that, so what do you think, I mean, I'm throwing this question to both of you, anyone can respond. What do you think Lagosians should do, having said this, to prevent the further spread of schistosomiasis?
Well, Lagos State government, because I'm working with the government, I can say that one of the cardinal programs of the government is health and education as well. Mm-hmm. And for what we are saying, we can see that if schistosomiasis and other neglected tropical diseases are not properly handled, it may affect educational capacity of the children or the potentials of the children. So Lagos State Government is really working hard to ensure that issues relating to health are adequately taken care of so that people can meaningfully be in good health and contribute meaningfully to the development of Lagos State and Nigeria as a whole. Mm. And again, considering the fact that the society, as in the people within the community, needs to be engaged in most of other health intervention for it to be effective. Mm-hmm. The community are actively involved in all our activities. Mm-hmm. So, by and large, I say that the government is really doing well to ensure that creates a positive impact within this society.
Okay, so your final thoughts, Dr. Daramola.
Thank you very much. I also want Lagosians to, you know, accept the program and then spread the news. We want media outlets to also join this fight because we've had targets that we need to eradicate this. Mm. And then this disease belongs to what we call neglected tropical diseases. So that means they've been neglected.
But they are existent.
Mm-hmm. They are around us. For that elephantiasis that you see people with swollen leg, it's the same mosquito
that we all know
that spreads that. So we're all at risk. It's a clear and present danger. So let's remove the veil of unawareness and let's all be aware that this is real. And let's come together, no matter our affiliations, and decide that we because this is a center of excellence, right? Mm-hmm. So let's excel in eradicating or eliminating neglected tropical diseases. And let's work on an environment too, because that tropical there speaks to our environment. Let's keep our environment clean, water, sanitation, hygiene. So we'll be doing a lot of our media engagements. The commissioner had a press meeting on Friday. So we implore Lagosians to support us to maintain the momentum. Let's not lower our voice in our meetings, in our routine activities, everywhere we go, market, churches, mosques. Let's talk about this. The time is now. Thank you very much.
All right.